Hi, in this tutorial I will show you how to create a bicycle helmet using a more conceptual way. So at the first stage of designing this helmet, I've been using drawing tools to do it. So I did a line, control point curve, and did a little bit of trimming. Then I moved to the second stage where I've created some solid using the sketches I've created previously. And I use a revolved and extrusion, and then I did a little bit of subtraction. So I've subtract one solid with another solid, and also I've been using help tools very much, like a constraints, planes, lines, to help me to do these sketches and made them solids. So follow me. I'm going to show step by step how to create this helmet. Okay, so let's start a new workspace. So it's good to know at the beginning of designing that it's very good and helpful to start anything from a center of coordinate system. So this will help you to make any operation on your stage as a mirror, symmetry, or just copying by axis. I've prepared some sketch before, so let's just now find it and place it. Sometimes it needs a little bit more adjustments, like rotating and placing in the point you want to be moving around. So if you are sure your image is placed in the right position, now we can start making a profile of our helmet. Just no rush, take your time and make this curve as you want it to be. So now I need to make another construction plane to put a sketch on it, and now I'm going to sketch another profile which I'm going to use it to cut the helmet shape. And now I'm going to revolve the shape I've created previously, so this will give me a nice solid. So now I'm going to use a loft tool. To do so, I need to have some more profiles, and I'm going to copy this sketch four times, two times at each side. So I'm going to use a mirror tool to do it, to copy on the other side of the object. So I'm going to select two of the opposite profiles and I'm going to slightly move them so the lofted shape is going to be more natural, and then my design going to be more realistic. So loft gives you ability to create really organic shapes. It depends on the profiles you use. Now I'm going to copy created revolved shape. I might need it later for cutting inside of a helmet. So let's create a new group in the layers, and then we're gonna move that created shape, copied shape, to that layers to have it later. Actually, putting objects into the group is very important, because you can get organized very well. Okay, so let's now create a curves to make the inside cutting. So remember, you have a control points. You can also adjust your shape later. So don't be very precise at the beginning of creating of the control point curves. You can always do it later. Okay, so when you finish your shapes, you just need to turn the helmet shape, and basically you just need to extrude those shapes you've just designed, and we're going to subtract like this. And it's ready. So we can go to another step, which will be making this shapes a little bit chamfered, so to look more like futuristic. So let's do the rest of them too. If you press this white popping up button, white button with dimension, you can adjust it by typing as they like, just exactly like this. This is a great feature, I like it so much. So now we might need this shape I've hidden before to cut it, to cut the helmet inside. We have to scale it a little bit. I've copied once again because I might need it again. So this is going to be outside shelf. I'm going to make the inside shelf like a stereo part, and then I'm going to cut again like so. And now subtract. So I will also need some chamfer on the shape I've already made. It's gonna look much better like that. Let's create some shapes, some sketches to cut inside holes. Okay. So more details you do in this case, the more realistic your helmet gonna look like. So. And of course, I'm going to extrude it and then subtract from the form I've made earlier, like so. So make sure every part is selected, then you're gonna have the holes as you made. And a little bit of chamfering or filleting, however you like. So this is conceptual work, so it can be done by you as you like. Okay, and I think I'm ready to cut the inside shape for the head, subtract it. So let's move it back to the right place, 25 millimeters. Okay. And then we're gonna scale a little bit. Remember to place the scaling point in the middle of some objects in a symmetry. Otherwise it's gonna be not properly scaled, not good direction. So if you cut, then your helmet is not gonna be symmetrical. All right, so we done it. Looks great already.